Good evening, East Africa and Kenya in general. This is Youth Cafe. It is Friday. We are live today from Panari and we have a live audience. This specific show is one important and unique show. My name is Nziki Biku.
And the hottest man in East and Central Africa, Brian Aseli. We are prepped up for a lot of things. Imagine we are going to test on air HIV status. Imagine.
That's right. We, Aseli and I, are going to test whether our HIV status, and that actually is what we're going to be discussing today. Now get this, 51%. That's the number, or rather the percentage, that people between the ages of 15 to 24 make when it comes to new adult HIV numbers. 51%. And that's the conversation we'll be having today. Make sure you use the hashtag YouthCafe, tweet us at KTN News, at Zinzi underscore K.
At Brian underscore Aseli.
But of course, as always, before we can dive into the conversation, we have to talk about a video that went viral, and I feel like it's very important because it feeds into the conversation.
Emotions, watu wa Mungu.
I know, I'm telling you that video. It was going by the name Heart Bay. It went viral online. 48 million views across Facebook, YouTube, and Twitter.
It was a conversation between two people, Courtney and Leonard.
Yeah.
Those guys are exes, and they had to open their hearts to each other.
Exactly.
It's
a six-minute video, Aseli, but we had to cut it down and give you the best scenes. Now, like Aseli has told you, they once dated, and then later on, they broke up. They live in two different states, but then they came together.
Imagine, unaambia urudi kukaa na ex wako, umwambie ni nini ili.
Exactly. And they talked about it. They talked about it, and that video went viral. All right? If you haven't seen it, don't worry. We have it, and it's coming right now on your screens, and you've watched it first right here on Youth Cafe. Check it out.
What did you do?
I did everything.
Like what?
I had sex with other girls. I did everything. In school, we met in college, we met in class, and you really didn't like me.
No, I didn't like you at first.
We spent a lot of time together.
Like, every day.
I would say that you were my best friend.
Yeah, me too. Like, see text messages or like pictures of girls, and then I would ask them about it. And sometimes you would lie and just say like, oh, that's not true, you don't know what you're talking about. And you said like, oh, I'll stop, but then you didn't. How many times did you cheat on me?
I don't know.
If you had to say.
I wasn't counting.
That video.
No, no, no. Rojo, baby, I did this because...
Let me tell you, the part that had everyone is when she asked, Courtney asked, how many times did you cheat on me? And you
many
know what?
Times.
Leonard had the guts to say,
many times.
I do not know. I do not know. I do not know. All right?
But baby, you're the best thing. I would like to see you in your next life growing up as a woman.
Surely.
Nijikute.
Don't, I know. That's
the
like
lie. Nijikute. No, I'm kidding. I haven't dated. I'm still single, ladies. Huh?
Calm down, Aseli. Aseli, calm
Hakuna
down.
Ile close up ile ya movie effect.
No, no. There's none whatsoever. There's none whatsoever.
All
right. Now, listen. Aseli, last week we celebrated World Condom Day.
Mm-hmm.
All right?
Mm-hmm.
And before we play for you a very important story in regards to that, before we even start the conversation, let me read for you something. Busia, Bungoma, Kakamega, Vihiga. Those counties, Aseli, are the ones that had the most increased HIV infections, more than a thousandfold.
And Zizi, do you know that 230 people get infected each and every hour, meaning there are 240,000 people out there who are just seated and they don't know they're infected.
And you Imagine. Do not know your status, all right?
Ndio maana leo lazima. Tumeshachukua kura leo, acha tuchukue status.
True. Good point, baby. Yeah. We've taken our voters' registration.
Bas.
And now today, we're going to know our HIV
Lazima
status.
Lazima tupime.
All right. Now, coming closer home, Nairobi and Mombasa cities have increased their new HIV infections by more than 50%. Now, that sounds very big. Let me give in a more elaborate term. Back in 2013, that number stood at around 4,000. In 2015, that number jumped all the way to 7,000.
Imagine.
That's how serious this conversation is that we're having today.
And those cases are rising each and every single hour. So imagine in the next hour, 230 new infections.
Leave alone that, by the year 2020, statistics show that we will be on a new high record when it comes to HIV infection. Mm-hmm. Yet, this is the same generation that has knowledge at our fingertips. Mm-hmm. And all anything else that we need to know at the press of a button. But why are we still the most ignorant generation?
I do not know. Let's check out the condoms day, how it was celebrated.
Aswa hapa mimi wakati nilikubali hii boma hakuna mtu alikuwa anakanyaga hata brother zangu walikuwa anakanyaga wakipita hapo kwa barabara kama amekunywa ile kitu yao kali wanasema ah huyu hata nini siku saba hazitaisha kama hatujazika
mtoto amezaliwa ni kijana wa expect hiyo kijana kulingana na mavazi yangu hii si mimi ni kijana nafaa niwe lakini hawawezi wakajua kwamba huyu mtoto ako na mwelekeo wa mapenzi kitofauti.
Busia County, at one end of Kenya's transport corridor, is home to these two men whose stories, though different, converge and paint a picture of what HIV and AIDS is in the country.
Kuna siku nilienda hospitali. Nilikuwa na boyfriend, then condom ikapasuka. Sasa nilienda hosi na kesi ya condom burst. Naona. But one of the health providers ananijua. Na ilikuwa Saturday. Nilienda asubuhi saa mbili, lakini kufika saa nane, nilikuwa bado sijahudumiwa.
Meet Wekesa, not his real name. He represents a community identified as a key population in the fight against HIV and AIDS in Kenya, the gay community, as he waited for medical service.
Ameshaita wenzake. Like 100 people wamekuja hapo, mtu amekujanga mwingine ametafuta kalamu yenye hakuna, mwingine amekuja ametafuta karatasi yenye hakuna. Hasa inakuwa ameenda amesignal. Hasa wakikuja mtu anakuja papa anatafuta hii ili ya kukuona.
Wekesa is a man whose experiences leave him with bittersweet memories of encounters with healthcare workers.
Juzi kulikuwa na mmoja wetu amekuwa na STI in the other funula Samia sub county. So, akaenda kwa daktari akamwambia kwa nasa akamwambia yeye ni fulani na amepata hii STI ako nayo. So ilikuwa aseme the partner. Unaona? Nti akasema the partner. Hey, ikakuwa sasa ni kumuombea kwanza.
He estimates that there are about 200 men who have sex with men at the Busia border.
Kwa hao 200, utapata kama 98 wako na virusi. Unajua shida ni kwamba, ama ukweli, kuna LGBTI wako mpaka kwa zile ndoa.
Nilijua hali yangu, mwaka 2002. Kati nilipima nikapatikana, niko na virusi.
John's story is different. He has been living the last 15 years positively, both in his HIV status and general outlook in life.
Naye mke wangu nilipompeleka akapimwa akapatikana ana virusi. Akaambiwa ngojee kwa miezi mitatu. Katushauri kwamba tunapofanya ngono tumie nini? Kondomu. Nilikubali. Yeye alikuwa mgumu kidogo lakini alikuja akakubali kwa sababu alikuwa akisema tangu azaliwe hajai tumia kondom.
Since then, John has been diligent.
Tokea mwaka 2003, tumetumia kondom mpaka dakika hii. Umuhimu wa kutumia kondom kwa kuzuia kuambukishana virusi. Ama kama wewe unaishi na virusi na mwingine ana virusi, kuzuia kuongezeana virusi. Umuhimu wa kutumia kondom ni kuzuia ugonjwa wa sinaa. Umuhimu wa kutumia kondom pata mimba ambao hujatarajia.
In fact, he has been teaching others on condom use.
Kishaona iko sawa, expiry date iko sawa sawa, unaifinya finya. Uone kwamba kuna pressure ndani. Ukiona iko na pressure namna hii, unajua hiyo iko sawa. Ukiona haina pressure, hiyo unajua imeharibika. Kisha maliza namna hiyo, utakata kapiska moja. Ukitaka kuitumia, utaangalia kuna mahali imewekwa kama makasi hivi. Utairarua.
John's story dates back to a time when his work was crossing from one border to the next.
Taka mke.
Tunahitaji tu.
Hizi viruzi naona kaa kwa sababu nimefanya kazi Nairobi miaka 18. Ah, kwa hiyo miaka 18 nikuja nikafanya kazi kama loaders. Kwa tukitoka hapo na Mwarabu na gari kwenda paka Mombasa, kwenda paka Tanzania. Kwa hizo nyarakati unajua ukiwa kwale, kwa hiyo msafara ukienda kulala utapata mwenzako na mtaelewana. Wakati hiyo hata mambo ya kondom ilikuwa haijaenea sana, ilikuwa tu ni sure, imeandikwa tu mahali sure, na ukienda kununua tena iko very expensive. Sasa watu wengine tulikuwa hatuangalie vitu kama hizo.
Many truck drivers, after kilometers from one border to the next, as we can see here, rest, and this becomes a high prevalence zone for HIV and AIDS, because as they rest in the night time, then it's high time for any other sexual activity.
Sometimes kuna huwa kuna kazi unaenda, labda unaenda mbali, unaweza enda maybe mwezi mmoja, hata wanaenda hata mwezi mbili.
Wa Kenya, that means sababu ninasikianga vile madereva wenzangu wanasemanga. In Kenya, a lot of people wanatumia condoms. Lakini in Uganda, they don't care.
Visa vya maambukizi viko juu kwa sababu tuko katika area ya mpakani. Kwa hivyo kuna watu wengi wameweza kutangamana na watu kutoka nchi ya Uganda.
Ukimwi unachangiwa na nchi yetu ya jirani sana. Wanapoenda kule uko Nalongo ama kule Sofia na Uganda kwa, na Uganda kwa ujumla, inasababisha ukimwi kuingia katika sehemu yetu ya Kenya.
Poverty has been cited as a major driver in the spread of HIV at the border. In their attempt to sell fruits and vegetables, young girls and women's bodies are not spared from the sale either.
Wanawake katika kuanzia miaka 15 hadi 24, ambapo tunaita vulnerable women and girls, ambapo wako katika hatari sana ya kuambukizwa.
Tuko na 4,500 trucker drivers ambao wanapita hapa. Na wanaweza kuwa kama trucker drivers at 1,005 ambao sasa wamefanya nini? Wameadhirika.
These different organizations and government agencies, including the National AIDS Control Council, have put in extra efforts, like having clinics at these border points to test drivers and continue some on their antiretroviral therapies while still in transit.
Umepata mteja anatoka Kampala, anaenda Mombasa. Leo hii amekupatia STI ama amekupatia gonorrhea, whatever, sindio, umeenda hosi. Watataka uende ulete huyo mteja. Surely, mtu ameenda kuongo, amepita hapa ameenda kuongo, utamfuata kuongo uende mrudishe.
In Busia County, the HIV prevalence is 6.7%. Yes, and that is 1.1% above the national prevalence. This county records quite a large number of what we call these populations, key populations. We have many, we'd call them sex workers, both male and female.
The open border policy has significantly improved cross-border economic activities, but on the other hand, stakeholders in the health sector are wary that control of the spread of HIV could get out of hand.
As truckers prepare to rest on the Kenyan side of the border or proceed to the Ugandan side of the border, then the nighttime ushers in another set of activities that have contributed significantly to the prevalence of HIV and AIDS in Busia County. Dr. Mercy Korir, KTN News, from the county of Busia.
All right, World Condoms Day, that was invented back in 2009. And it's very important. And that was our Dr. Mercy Korir, who gave us an entire preview about that. And that's the conversation that we'll be talking about today. And like, if you've just joined us, some of the statistics that we had to share is that those between the ages of 15 to 24 make up 51% of new HIV infections. I know, that's very scary. And that is why we're having today's conversation. Aseli, mm-hmm. I mean, come on.
Nakwambia.
Right here in Kenya,
nakwambia,
the most vibrant country.
You know, in the world, 230 people each and every hour. Imagine. Yani tukipiga hesabu sahihi ka hour kakiisha 230 new infections.
No, it's scary. And let me introduce the panel, the people who will be joining us to talk about it. And by the way, we have a live audience today, which I'm very excited about, and we'll get to mingle with them. Mm-hmm. And you at home, you can also be involved. Use the hashtag Youth Cafe, and we'll be able to read some of your tweets live right here, where we're having the show from Panari. Mm-hmm. All right, on my far end is none other than Roberta, who is a blogger. And if you've come across her blog, you'll know that she doesn't shy away from speaking the truth. Mm-hmm. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
I love your outfit.
Thank you.
Purple is the day, the color.
Royalty.
All right. Next to Aseli, MC Baridi, who is called, no, his title, Preventional.
Preventional Ambassador. Not Officer, Ambassador. Ujalu itakuwa. Karibu sana.
MC Baridi, welcome. I love your whole turtleneck, green.
Yeah.
Are you doing like a whole Steve Jobs? Because Steve Jobs also used to wear like a black turtleneck.
Usimjaze kiburi ni mjalu.
Just asking.
This one is from Italy.
From Italy. Hapa tu kwa Moi Avenue ya Italy. Hapo tu ukipita hapa mudhuru ya
Italy ya kawangware.
Even more. And right here we have Solomon. Solomon, who is a student with Cambridge University in Eldoret. All right, what are you studying? No, I mean,
Cambridge University in Eldoret. Hey. Umechoma, ingekuwa England.
I'm sorry. Fine. Okay, what are you studying? Talk to us.
I study ICT.
ICT.
Yes.
And let me tell you, Solomon has a very inspiring and interesting story, which some of us can borrow a few of those. But let's begin with you, MC Baridi. Yeah. You are a preventional ambassador.
Yeah.
Some of these statistics are quite scary, to be honest. Why is it in 2017, and this report came out in 2015, not so far long ago, we are the generation that has smartphones. We have information at our fingertips. I know there's the issue of peer pressure that is there, but I think also we are the most confident generation. I mean, you're always on InstaChat, now WhatsApp chat, you know.
Showing off everything.
We are the most vocal generation, but then again, there's this issue that we do not take responsibility because 51%, that's a scary number. Why are we seeing that?
Okay, I'm MC Baridi from BLAST under NEFAC and NASCO. And in 2015, we got new infection, 35,000 young people, 15 to 24 age. Then we lost 14,000 young people.
14,000?
To
HIV?
Yes, to AIDS. HIV does not kill.
HIV, AIDS, yes.
So these things are happening because of society and this and communication. We don't have that communication, how to talk to these young people and everything. We are going back to Western, and that's why we are getting these things, because our parents are too busy. They don't want to talk to young people. Why this thing is happening? If you go to school, if you go to high school, teachers are too busy wanting to get an A and go to university. Don't discuss.
Teachers are too busy to get an A.
Yes.
They do not discuss.
Nothing. Even they have life skills lessons. Some of school, they don't even use it, even to teach it. Mm-hmm. If you go to home, parents are too busy, want to pay school fees, look for, they are busy in chama everywhere, writing reports and everywhere. When you go back to church, pastors are too busy, want to receive Christ and go to heaven.
I like that point. Let me just add to that. I like the fact that you said parents are too busy and they're finding our next school fees, where to put food on the table, and that's okay. But there's also the issue that in Africa, the stereotype of we cannot talk about sex with our parents. How many of us have had the birds and the bees, the flower, you know, the conversation of sex with our parents? How many of us have been told, come, it's about time we have this conversation? Do you think that also our African culture kind of, you know, builds on that atmosphere?
Tradition is the worst enemy of civilization in African society.
Mm.
If you go to Europe, if you go to South Africa, your parent will tell you, when you're going to club, please carry a condom.
Mm-hmm.
When you're having sex, this is your private part.
Mm.
But hapo utaambia ni dudu, mtu asishike. And when you want to experience it outside, young people are scared of pregnancy and HIV because of the shame.
Mm-hmm.
They say that I can take care of this and I can be fat. If you get AIDS, HIV in my house, I will suck. Okay, then I will not get it, but I will use whatever I want to do outside.
True. Mm-hmm. Okay.
When you go to, yes. So those are the challenges that we're having each and every time, that now you have to go back to the parents and talk to parents. Parents have to talk to their kids.
Mm-hmm.
Tell your kids, young people, the youngest mother in Kenya, I think right now she's 15.
The youngest, 15.
Yeah.
And that's, you see, 15 right there, and that's the age gap, 15 to 24, who make 51% of new HIV infection.
Yes. So if you cannot talk to these people, they start experiencing sex at primary school, high school, form one, form two. When you go to bash, when you go to to school, to fun kids and coming back. There's a bedroom in the matatu, in the school bus. Uko nyuma, inakuanga bedroom when you're coming from the festival. Yes, na unazima light. And also mwalimu ingi.
Oh,
so whatever you are doing with these girls, you know, when you go to watch set books, you have sex up there because there's darkness. Yeah, there's no prevention.
You know, Roberta is laughing. And Aseli, the thing with Roberta, she has a very incredible blog.
Exactly. She's an erotic writer and you're also a student. So tell us, is it hard for you to talk to your parents about sex? That's why you write about it? Or you just decided to write about sex because this generation is not serious with the information they are getting?
Actually, my parents are very supportive. No. My parents listen to me. They talk to me. I think I'm very lucky I have parents I can talk to because I tell them, hey, mom, sex. She at first, she wasn't really as open because, like we said, tradition, culture. I guess it's just an African thing. But when I'm the one, I think I'm just a vocal person. I talk, I write, I express myself. So I'll say, hey, mom, sex, condoms. And she just buys into it. Even my dad, we actually have these conversations in the house. I started writing because I realized there's not much people who are maybe as lucky as I am. People don't have parents like mine. You know, when you're seated with your friends and you're hearing, hey, you know, I want to try sex, but mamangu, nini, nini, nini. And me, I have this information. I read. My mom talks to me. So maybe I can share with the people who do not know how they're going to approach maybe their parents.
Yeah, but there's so many erotic writers who write about the flavor of sex and they don't talk about prevention. What have you done to stand in the gap?
Actually, that's how I began. I began by just writing about relationships and things related to relationships. Then I joined Generation Next, which is an organization, as well as, Campus Heart, whereby we do sensitization about HIV and we give out condoms. And we mostly it's about social media influencers who have a greater outreach. So we're able to reach people of my age, younger, older maybe, and we get to sensitize them with what my blog does is that it talks about sex, but I also include the consequences and I will throw in somewhere about a condom or HIV. So it's not just about how sex is nice, but also about what you need to do so that you can enjoy sex safely.
Okay. Solomon, let me engage you a little bit. You're also in university. Baridi told me your story. For you, it's different. You didn't choose it. You were born with a virus. How And the fact that you're in school and you have this as, what challenges do you go through? Are you looked down upon in school? Has it affected your social media? I mean, not social media, but your social circles. And I think more of how you interact with people.
Actually, I can say that I have not passed through challenges. My name is Ben Solomon. You can, Solomon, for instance. I go with a company called Blast. So, okay, well, when I was saying, like, I can't go, as in Swezi, like, sema tisijai pitia yoshida, because I've passed through a lot of challenges whereby you can't speak to someone because you know that mentality whereby people tell you that, ukisimama sijui na mtu mwenye ako na HIV, they can't stand with you, something like that, they can't sijui eat with you.
The stereotypes.
So, yeah, challenges are there.
How has your story enabled, I'm sure it has empowered you, because you talk about it. Do you see a change when you talk to the youth, when you tell them, listen, I am a living example, but I need you to now, because you don't have the virus yet, but I need you to take responsibility. And if you do, it's not the end of the world. When you're interacting with other youth, do you feel a sort of, do you feel positivity that, yes, okay, I will go outside there and do something, or it's those ones of, I don't care, what is this guy talking about?
Are you speaking about ignorance or?
Yes, exactly.
Okay, actually, it's not good to be ignorant with these things, because actually, when you tell someone about your life and you don't tell someone about your status, you're actually saving that person. Simply because, like you've said, the high rate of HIV is increasing. So when you tell someone, you're saving a life. You're saving a life. You're saving a little bit of life.
Ebu niambie, Solomon. Do you look at a lady, you fall in love with this lady who's not HIV positive, and how do you tell them, I love you, but I cannot be with you? Because how do you tell them that I am HIV positive? And how, as in, I don't know if you're getting me, audience. As in, chali, unapenda uchali na uchali anakuambia niko na AIDS. Uji vile aliipata, hata kali zaliwa nayo. Reaction yako itakuwa nini, unaget?
Ako na HIV.
Ako positive, AIDS.
AIDS is the last.
Sawa.
HIV is the virus.
Uh-huh.
You can't see AIDS person walking.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So HIV is the virus that is bringing AIDS.
Okay, yeah. Same AIDS.
Same HIV.
So if I'm not HIV. Wrong, I'd say this question is, when you're carrying the virus
yeah.
and you seem to have a crush on you know, person X, and
how do you
confront that? How do you tell them, listen, I like Baby you, girl. But you've got to know this about me.
Mm-hmm.
How have you seen yourself in such a situation?
First, you have to know what is love.
Eish, hey. We're getting deep. What is
getting
love?
Spiritual here. Love is patient, love is kind.
Uh-huh. I like that.
No, love is not patient and it's not kind.
Hey.
Love is just being honest with that person.
Mm.
You're just simply saving that person. That is love. Sacrificing for that person.
So has it ever been a boundary? Am I make fanya mazijo kuna udimu menoki maze ile kuruka alafu uwezi hata mu approach kwa sababu na feel yenyewe udema meiva na ni blanda jo nikimwambia niko hivi na hivi.
Actually I have not got one.
One personal question, do you have a girlfriend?
Yes, I do.
You do.
Okay,
yes.
Now I like this.
What to call single?
She's a confident one. I like that. Okay, MC Baridi, some of the things that we, as our generation, have been we do not shy away from is the issue of sponsors or sponsoress.
Correct.
Let's not forget the sponsoress version.
Or the sponsored.
Sponsored. Yeah, in South Africa, we call them blessers.
Hey.
Because you've been blessed.
Hashtag blessed.
With whatever car you're driving. Listen, but MC Baridi, the issue of sponsors and sponsoress, would you say it feeds into this issue?
Yeah, it's a big problem. They call us investors, the sponsors one.
Investors.
Yeah. We invest, we give, but we tunatoka na mdomo bure.
While
them, they sponsor and they go with the food. So, in Blast, I personally am in more than 100 WhatsApp groups.
You're in 100 WhatsApp groups?
Yeah, with two different numbers.
Okay.
In campuses. Group where people like Roberta are, where
Blast.
They blog,
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Sex,
mm-hmm.
I mean, the Holy Communion family, I mean, everywhere. Mm-hmm. But I have also people that are they don't believe anything. They only believe in sex.
Mm-hmm.
They only believe in sex.
No protection.
No protection. Sex is cool.
One night stands.
Yes.
It could come
ni hivyo.
Yeah.
Yes, usini waste time.
Yeah.
So, so these sponsors, they are doing a lot of things to our people. Some of them want to have sex with these people without protection and threatening your life.
Mm-hmm.
And even some have died, even right now, even last year. That some died, some just disappear. Because of the sponsors and sponsors, they promised you heaven and you have to deliver. They will give you heaven.
Mm.
They'll give you a car.
Mm.
They'll buy you a land. They'll give you a house. But now, they'll have sex with you.
Mm.
But there's a time they'll tell you, no, now we can't use the protection. But you have to insist that you have to use the protection. And then from there, you start bringing issues. So this is what, and most of young people that are getting infected right now, most of them are getting them from these sponsors.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Wow. All right. Let's leave it at that conversation. We're going to take a short break and come back. And when we come back, we're going to read some of your views and also engage the audience, hear what they have to say. But Aseli went to the streets of Nairobi as usual, and he had a chance to catch up with you guys and ask, have you been tested? When was the last time you got tested? Mm-hmm. If yes, no, why? Take a look at this.
BEA Beautiful Moments in the City Streets of Nairobi. Nimekutana hapa hivi na wanaume wamesema ni maternal healthcare. Sidio? Studio? Yeah, and they have a lot of things to say. I'm asking one question, very simple question. Have you ever been tested? If yes, no, why? Sindio, wacha tusikie. Wanaume mnasemaje? Have you ever been tested?
Yes, I've been tested for HIV and AIDS. Mm-hmm. I tested for the last 3 months,
mm-hmm.
and I'll be testing again come next month.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Ebu tuambie jina yako na kama umetest.
So I mean it was start to born first.
Mm-hmm.
I'll test last year mwisho, around June.
Mm-hmm.
Size huwa normally huwa na test wakati kuna ile mobilization.
Mm.
So far sijaona watu mahali kuna mobilization, kuna ile inakuwa outreach ile. Mm. Sijaona mahali kuna outreach. But nikipata moja nitaenda tu test. Yeah.
So wewe ni lazima uchochwe ndio ufanye maneno.
Okay. Inakuwa ngumu saa zingine kwenda VCT because I know we have VCT centers. Mm. Na inakuwa rahisi wakati kuna ile mobilization unapata na watu kwa tent kwa street. Inakuwa rahisi hivyo. So that's normal hapo ndo naenda inakuwa rahisi kwangu. So most of the time tuko kwa street tukizuru watu kisha waso. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
E, naona kuna mwanaume amevaa hapa ngepa na madigaga. Kujichocha. Hebu tuambie kama umetest.
Mimi naitwa Linus. Nilitest lakini haikuwa willingly. Tulikuwa na watu wakaniambia tuende tutest. So nilienda juu aliniambia tuende tutest. Yeah, it was like 2 years ago. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
2 years ago. So kutest ni umetest. Utarudi tena juu unajua 2 years ni muda mrefu.
Sioni sijishuku. Kwa hivyo sioni kama nitarudi huko tena. Sina mpango.
Wana ume, tuambie jina lako na utuambie kama umeitest.
Timothy, yes, nime-test. Mimi nafanya after every 3 months. The reason why kwa sababu ya kudonate blood. So, sunajua lazima utestiwe alafu. So, kudonate blood unafanya half, 6 months, 6 months. Testing ni after every 3 months. Yeah.
Huko umetuambie jina yako na please tuambie, we advice yako kwa wale watu unyoko huko inje na waja test. Unaweza wambia aje?
Okay, jina yangu ni John. Mimi ni nurse. I'm a practicing nurse. So I test as a routine practice in the hospitals. So ningetaka watu wawe wakifanya routinely. Yes, you don't have to wait to be told to go and test. So make it a practice. Yes.
Hawa watu kwa nje unawaambiaje?
Nipo ukipata mahali watu wanatestiwa, uende ujumike nao utestiwe kama hujai test. Sababu ni vizuri kujua hali yako, usihatarishe maisha ya watu wengine.
Asante na wewe.
Walking in a VCT, kuna vile si kitu mzuri sana na mimi, but I'm a regular blood donor, na natoanga damu, like this is around 12 times right now, so I'll say I'm safe, but anyway, it's good that for the youth to wenda wajitest, wajua wakopua, kama wakopua, if not, wapewa ARVs and watu waishi healthy.
Amiko angu. To the people outside. Okay, my advice is quite simple. If you want to go get tested, fanya na mwenzako. Yani if you are in a relationship, obviously most people ambao wako 15, they are in relationships. If you want to do it in a better kind of scenario, enda na mwenzako. It's the best advice you can give yourself. Ukienda peke yako ama ukienda na rende yako itajua. So unajua ile kama tini ama youth, at some mtu atakuwa for the next maybe 20 years, atakama nyini mabeshti, atajua status yako. So even if you are negative, alafu utakuwa tu positive, kamoja tu vikidogo, maneno yako kwisha. Lakini ukienda na mwenzako, atakusave tu. Yeah.
Asante sana. Well, you've heard it from the youth, my youth. Wengi wanasema ni lazima wachochwe ndio waende wakafanya test. Wengine wanasema si lazima juu wana shuku vitu mob. And that's all from the street sense.